What you're seeing here are 1000 double pendulums. I initiated them with an extremely tiny difference in their initial positions, nearly identically. But after a short time, they quickly diverge and pursue different trajectories. In this video, I want to explore what determines how fast or slow these pendulums diverge. First of all, I want to compare what happens if we increase the number of limbs of the pendulum. I'm starting by adding a third limb to it, so we can call this pendulum here a triple pendulum. Double pendulum is a classical example for a chaotic system, but triple pendulums have been a little bit less explored, at least if you search for them on YouTube. What both systems have in common is that I initiated all the 1000 pendulums here with a tiny difference in their initial angles of just 0.0016%. That means less than a percent of a percent in difference. Let's do the same now for a quadruple pendulum, a pendulum with 4 limbs. Again, I am launching 1000 of these with the tiny difference in initial angle. It is a bit difficult to compare the results of the three types of pendulums without visualizing them next to each other. That's what we are gonna do a bit later. But for the moment, let me explore another factor first, namely in which direction the pendulum is pointing in the beginning. On the left, the initial angles, which we denote by theta, are pointing rather downwards. I will call this the low case. In the center, the pendulums are pointing toward the right at an angle of 90 degrees. That's what I will call the medium case. And in the last case, the pendulum is pointing rather upwards, which I will call the high case. This is the case we've already seen before. In this simulation, there's no friction. So we can also think about low, medium, and high as the amount of energy that these pendulums are initiated with and that they conserve during their trajectories. What do you think? Which of these is going to diverge quickliest? Interestingly, it is the one in the middle. That is quite surprising and I don't really have an explanation for it. If you have one, please leave it in the comments. Meanwhile, I will explore the same for the two other pendulums. Even more surprising, here the order seems to be different. The first pendulums to diverge are the ones with high energy. Shortly afterwards, the pendulums with the medium angles diverge. Then, for a time, nothing seems to happen with the low energy pendulums. Until they also diverge. Let's now look how the quadruple pendulums behave for different initial directions. As it turns out, they constitute a different case. For some reason, the ones with the high energy on the right diverge super quickly, but the other ones never diverge. At least not in the first 35 seconds for which I ran the simulation. I'm sure that they would diverge at some point, but I would have to run the simulation much longer, so we won't see that. To compare what's happening overall, I will now visualize all the 9 pendulums we've just seen next to each other on the same screen. As we can see now much more clearly, the way the pendulums behave depends on both the number of limbs and on their starting position. Most interestingly, increasing the energy of the system by changing the starting position sometimes makes the pendulum more and sometimes less chaotic. The effect is ambiguous. Let's see this once more in slow motion. The double pendulum with the high energy on the top right somehow does not behave like its neighbors in the grid. That is the interesting thing about chaos and topics of complexity. They are emergent phenomena that are just hard to predict by looking at the theory only. We need to experiment and observe. It would be interesting to explore this further, for example, by varying the angles in a more continuous way and comparing the results. I could even see how a fractal might emerge from this, similar to our previous video, which you should definitely check out. But this remains to be explored in another video. If you want to motivate us to keep working on this topic, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. That will tell YouTube to suggest the video to other users.